Hello guys and welcome to my channel. If you own a Raspberry Pi 4 and wants to use it for your astrophotography session, first thing you need to do is to install an operating system on it. Today in this video, I am going to tell you guys how to install a Linux distribution called Ubuntu. Before we go further, if you have not seen my video of how to select a correct SD card for your Raspberry Pi 4 or an unboxing video of Raspberry Pi 4 and how to assemble a Raspberry Pi 4, I will put the links in the video above or put the links of the videos in the description below for you guys to check it out. Before we go further, please ensure that you watch this video till the end so that you do not miss out on any important information that I have to share. So if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button and click that bell icon to get the notifications for all my new videos. Let's get started. To download the Raspberry Pi operating system, you need to go to Raspberry Pi operating system website. I will put the link in the description below. So here on this website, you have to go to the software section and you will see the Raspberry Pi OS section. In this Raspberry Pi OS section, we need to download the Raspberry Pi Imager. This is the software that is used for installing the operating system on your SD card for your Raspberry Pi 4. So there are many information available on this web page. If you want, you can go through it. First thing we need to do is to install the setup that we have downloaded for Raspberry Pi Imager. We'll look at this setup later. First, see what else we have on this website. So you see there are many operating systems available for Raspberry Pi 4 that you can download, but we are interested in Ubuntu Desktop. So let's go to the download page of Ubuntu Desktop. So you see it will take you to the Ubuntu website. Here there are many versions of Ubuntu available as well. If you want, you can download any preferred operating system that you need. Here you can see you can download Ubuntu Server as well. So this is the server version. If you want, you can download and use. So this will be an offline downloader. And you can download this image and save it to your desktop. However, Raspberry Pi Imager downloads the operating system for you as well. So either way, whichever is preferred, you can do that. So let's run the Raspberry Pi Imager from the start menu. First thing you need to do is select the operating system. Here you see there are many options given. Here we'll select this option. Inside this option, you will see the Ubuntu operating system as well. So here is the first option. We'll download the desktop version of Ubuntu. So once you click on this desktop version and select the SD card, ensure that you select the correct SD card. Otherwise, it will erase everything which is there on that SD card. Next thing you need to do is click on write. It will give you the warning that everything on this SD card will be deleted. So once the SD card is formatted, this Raspberry Pi Imager will start writing the operating system on this SD card that you have selected. Once the writing is complete, it will verify if everything was written correctly, and then it will issue another message saying that your operating system is installed on the SD card. You can insert it into your Raspberry Pi 4 now for the first boot. Now let's see and insert this SD card in your Raspberry Pi 4 and boot it for the first time. So this is how it looks once you first boot your operating system. It will ask you to select the language and the layout of the keyboard. As of now, I have a Spanish keyboard with me, so I will be selecting the Spanish keyboard. If you have English keyboard, you can select the English keyboard. So this keyboard, just to let you know, is a Bluetooth keyboard or a keyboard that I have attached to my Raspberry Pi using USB port. Next thing, it will ask you to connect to a network. If you have a Wi-Fi, you can connect to your Wi-Fi. I have a Wi-Fi. I will connect to the Wi-Fi. It will ask for the password. I will enter the password and click connect. Once you click on connect, it will take some time to get the IP address. Once it is connected, it will ask you for the time zone. So as of now, currently I am in Mexico City, so I will select my current location and time zone. Once you click on the continue, it will ask you for your name, username and password. So I will put my username or name as Astro Shooting Stars. It will give my name of the computer as Astro Shooting Stars Desktop. If you want, you can change that. I am going to leave that as same. So next thing, it will ask you for the password. As of now, it will not give you any errors for the password. Whatever password you want to choose, I will choose like 12345 is enough for me and simple, so that I can log in quickly. So next important thing is always require password option has to be selected, so that it does not log in automatically always when you boot the Raspberry Pi 4. Then it will do some configurations and it will start installing the operating system depending upon the selections that you have made before, and it will apply the changes. Sit back and relax, let it finish. It will take some time to apply all the changes and everything and to bring it to your desktop. So just wait, and then it will, you will have this black screen and everything. It is not restarting, it is just that it is preparing the desktop and it will bring your login page for now. So as you can see, your login is ready. Click on the username that you created, then it will ask for your password. Enter your password and hit enter. It will take you to this online accounts page for the first time. If you want, you can connect your Google account or Microsoft account. I will not do it for now. It will ask you for reporting the errors. I will keep it to default. I will turn on the location services so that I will have my updated time every time I boot my Raspberry Pi. Next thing that it will show is some of the software options that you can install. For now, I will skip it, and then I will go to the start option or menu option. Here I will go to the settings and go through some settings that I want to change. So here you see you have settings icon. Click on the setting icon, it will open the setting menu. It is very similar to Windows. So here you can see you have, if you have a Wi-Fi, you can change it or connect it to another Wi-Fi or network. So for now, I am going to add another keyboard. To do that, we have to go to regions and language. Here you see you have a Spanish keyboard for now. If you use an English keyboard later, I think you can add a English keyboard from here. Search an English keyboard or any other language keyboard that you use, and you can add an additional keyboard. It will show as a drop down menu on the top right corner, so you can switch between the keyboards easily. So next thing we can do here is to add multiple users or change user settings. To do that, you have to go to user section. Here you can customize the user, change the icon of the user, or on the top right corner, once you unlock it, you can add another user. Here you see automatic login is turned off. So again, let's go to the menu option and update this operating system to the latest patch. To do that, click on the software update icon. Once you click that software update icon, it will start checking for the updates. And it will ask you to download any updates if it is available at that point of time. Once you click on install now, it will ask you to enter the username password. Once you enter your password and authenticate, it will start installing the updates. First it will download and then install. Once installation is finished, it will ask you for restart later or restart now. For now, I will restart. So this will upgrade your operating system to the latest patch level. Once it is rebooted, it will ask you for the password again. Enter your password and hit enter. It will take you to the desktop. So now let's check if there are any further updates available. Click on update icon. You can pin it to the activities on the left side. As you can see, once the update is checked, it will prompt you and say that if there are any update available. For now, my computer is up to date. There are no further updates required. So next thing we are going to do is install some of the important software that we need on regular basis. So let's see, there are three sections on the top: explore, installed, and updates. On the update section, you see There are some of the software which are already installed that need requires an update. Click on update all to update all the softwares to the latest version. It will ask you for your login password. Enter the password and authenticate. So it will start installing each one of them. Now let's go to the explore section on the top. On the installed section, you will see whatever is installed on your system, but on the explore section is where you can find the software using the search option of the top left corner. For now, we'll install the VLC first, just to play some video files if you have. For media and entertainment, just click on install. It will again ask you for your login password. Just put in your password and authenticate. It will install. Now let's go back and install another software. For now, we are going to install another browser called Chromium. You can use Firefox, which comes pre-installed, but I like Chromium more, so I am going to install Chromium. So it is the same process. Click on install. It will ask you for the password. Authenticate it. It will start downloading and installing your Chromium browser on your operating system. Alright, once it is installed, let's go back and install another software that we need for image editing, which is GIMP. So it will be there on the top, or you can search if it is not there. Click on install. It will ask for the password and it will install. So if you want to remove any of the software, all you have to do is search the software and click on remove button that is there on the bottom. It will ask you for the confirmation. Once you click on the confirmation, it will uninstall. GIMP, you need it for any astrophotography session to stack the image or edit the image. I would not recommend to use it on Raspberry Pi, but you can do it, right? So next thing that we are going to do is check some of the system parameters which are there, right? So to check the system parameters, go on to the utilities section and click on system monitor. It will open up on another window that will show all the processes, resources that it is using. As you can see, it is Raspberry Pi 4, so it is a quad core processor, so it has 4 processors, how much RAM it is using, right? So all the stuff, you can check the file system, how much space that is available on your system as of now, right? So next thing that we are going to check is disk utility to check how much space. So you can check it from system monitor or disk analysis tool as well. So how much space is there in your or in your home folder or on your system in total, how much space is available. So that is one thing. So last thing I'm going to show you is some of the softwares, as you know, which are already pre-installed that you can see. Right, so there are some games also that is pre-installed that you can play. So that is all. So once you have already installed all the software, let's check once more if there are any further updates available. As you can see, checking the updates is finished almost. You can see my computer is up to date. So that is it, guys. That is how you install Ubuntu on your Raspberry Pi 4. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. I will try and answer as soon as possible. If you like this video, please hit that like button. If you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button and click that bell icon to get the notifications for all my new videos. Thank you, guys. Thanks for watching, and clear skies.